Hey guys, Chris Fix here, and today I'm going to show you how to replace an air fuel ratio sensor on a 2003 Toyota RAV4. You can see here we have a check engine light for code P1155, and this code indicates a bank 2 sensor 1 air fuel ratio sensor error. This is a common problem for Toyotas and Lexus engines. Typically the heater element in the sensor goes bad, and I'll show you how to test that before you go out buying a new sensor, since they can be expensive. The process will be the same for any Toyota or Lexus with this 2-liter 4-cylinder engine. So here's our exhaust manifold where the new sensor screws into. You want to make sure the engine is cool because this gets very hot and you'll burn yourself. So what you're looking for is bank 2, sensor 1. This is the sensor right here. So the first thing we're going to do is test the sensor to make sure the sensor is the actual problem. To do that, we'll go right over here. You follow this line, you make sure it's for bank 2, sensor 1. Follow it up, press on this tab here, and as you're pressing on this tab, you're going to pull out, and then you could see on here there's two black wires on top and then a blue and a white on the bottom. You want to test the two black wires. So we have our ohm meter. I'm going to set it to 200 ohms. We'll take our sensor here, and again you want to go to the two black wires right there, which are going to be the top of this pigtail here. Connect each lead of the multimeter to each black prong in the pigtail. You can see there's no continuity, so the heater circuit is broken. Let's compare this to the sensor that works. So here's a brand new sensor, and I'll show you what it should look like. The two black wires are on the top right here. You just attach one prong and attach the other. And you can see there is resistance, and obviously this is a good sensor because it's brand new. Now that we verified the sensor is bad, let's replace it. I just got back from the parts store and we rented this oxygen sensor socket, and it has a special slot so you could slide the sensor wire in it. You definitely want to use this socket because it'll make the job go smoothly and you won't strip the old sensor while you're trying to take it out, plus it'll help for installation of the new sensor. I'll put a link to a good oxygen sensor socket kit in the description. So be careful working on a hot engine. All you're going to do is you're going to get this, slide the wire in, slide that down, then get your ratchet on there. Unfortunately, this kit fits a 3/8 ratchet, but my breaker bar is a 1/2 inch ratchet. So what I'll do is I'll use a cheater bar. Just put a piece of long tubing over your ratchet and twist. This is really hot. Once you crack it open, you'll be able to take it off by hand. I have a welder's glove. You can either let this cool off or get in there with your welder's glove. Just unscrew this all the way now. Pull that out. So here's the new air fuel ratio sensor. I'll have a link in the description to where you could get one cheaper than at the parts stores. As always, you check to make sure that the sensor is the same and it looks identical, has the same length and everything. It comes with this anti-seize, which is good. You're just going to add a little bit of anti-seize right on the threads. Don't get it on the actual sensor itself. You don't want that. Just on the threads, and that'll make it a lot easier to come off if you ever have to replace these again. You don't need a lot of this stuff. Just get it on like that and push it in with your finger. Just get in the threads, and that looks perfect. You do not need a lot of this stuff. Now let's go thread it into the hole and tighten it up. Be careful not to cross thread this. Make sure it goes in nice and smoothly. And once you get it threaded in, tighten it up all the way. Get your oxygen sensor socket. And snug it up. You don't need to make this super tight, you just need to get it real snug. Good. And then after we tighten this, we're going to just connect the clip right in here. That snaps in, like so. So we have our new air fuel sensor going up, clipped in. And now let's delete the codes to check engine light and see if it gets triggered again. So we have our bank 2 sensor 1 code right here. We're going to delete it. Good. Now we'll start the engine. And we'll go for a ride and see if the check engine light comes back on. After the ride, you could see the light didn't come back on, so we fixed the problem. That's how you check and replace an air fuel ratio sensor. Hopefully the video was helpful. If it was, remember to give it a thumbs up. Also, if you're not a subscriber, what are you waiting for? Hit that subscribe button.